That I got earlier today by email from someone. I appreciate all you guys emailing me stuff. I probably have a couple more to go through. I do. Hold on, let me see. Oh, somebody sent me some of the pictures. I'm not gonna show the name, but yeah, somebody sent me some of the screenshots already.
And ghosts are not besties.
Oh, they're so great. They're so great. That might be my favorite.
I can include them in my little, collage. I thank you for the person that sent me those. I don't know if you want your name put out there, so I won't say. And then, oh, somebody sent me some screenshots of some of the enablers.
Oh.
Ooh, and some messages.
Ooh, indeed. Let's hear them.
I don't want to show it because it shows the person's name and
Right, of
legal name,
course.
but someone messaged an enabler, and they said to this enabler, "You just paid for Lisa's rugs," and
Yeah.
it responded back, "What does it effing matter? It's my money."
What does it matter? Are you willing to also pay for her funeral?
And then this person said, "So you want to unalive her?" She said,
Right.
"Unless you're feeding me, effing me, or financing me, don't worry about my money." And then the person said, "LMFAO, wow." And then they responded back with rolling eye faces and said, "Get a life.
Ugh.
Get a life and quit bullying other people."
It is not bullying. That is
Right.
not bullying.
And then this person replied back, "You'll be all over the anti-scam pages, babe, just letting you know. Girl, no one is bullying you. You're buying rugs for people." And then
Right.
she said, "No, me," like meaning not me, her. So she knows. Not me, her.
Knows, and she's still doing it.
Yeah. And then this person said, "Lisa is a rug addict who refuses to work. She had her son taken from her 2 weeks ago because she's on rugs and you're contributing." And this person, the other person responded, the enabler said, "And I gotta have faith that she'll do right." So
Ugh.
then this person said, "You're hilarious." And she said, "How? I know that it's unlikely she will," meaning get Jace back, "but I gotta have faith in humanity, man. And watching people berate her makes my heart hurt."
We're not berating her.
No. And then this person said, "Well, why give her money?" And she said, "Maybe because maybe she is hungry. Maybe she needs toilet paper.
Ugh.
Maybe she needs tampons. Maybe she needs anything other than rugs. I don't know."
No,
This person's delusional because she is
yeah.
using that money for rugs. She's not using it for toilet paper and tampons and So then this person responded perfectly. She said, "There are resources for that." "How
Right.
long have you been watching her? You're obviously new. Look up Lisa Richard on YouTube." And then this
Right.
person, the enabler, said, "Yeah, I am new. Not to TikTok, but to this I am." And then she said, this person said, "You really need to do research, love." And then the enabler says, "I have been down and out. I have needed things. And while I would never resort to begging online or anywhere, I understand that some people do. And I am an empath and a Libra, and my heart can't handle it if I see someone needing something." She says, "I am looking now because she blocked me after I sent her $20." So yeah, humans suck. Oh, what happened to her having all this hope and
Right.
faith? What happened to her having all this hope and faith in Lisa? Now, humans suck.
Yeah, funny that.
She's getting a real quick lesson here. And then the enabler says, "She just blocked me because I told her I saw a video of her nodding and that her son was removed. And is that true? Her son was removed," and she put a sad face. She said, "I saw where he was begging her to get offline." This is a messages that someone sent to me. And then this person told her, "Join Scam Slam 412 Live. Please join and share your story."
Yes.
So I don't know if she's been in here because I just looked at this. I do see her username. I don't recall seeing it here tonight, but it is possible because I don't see all of the names. Once I clean this up and I make sure I have her the profile pictures and names redacted, I can show you these, but I just can't show you those right now because I
Right.
don't want to give out anybody's names. And that person is welcome in here if they do want to share what happened with them or anything else. And we're not gonna, yes, people, I see you're saying people are gullible and how do people not know and all that, but it is true. There are people that have not heard of her. There, it like for us, because we see other scammers, the algorithm makes us see other scammers all the time.
Right.
That's why they seem to keep popping up for us.
Yep.
Okay. Once you start watching one, they keep popping up in your algorithm. But if there's a person, and just I'm just going to give you an example. Let's say there's a person that joins TikTok and they're into gardening. So they start watching gardening videos and they're watching gardening and it's pretty much all gardening stuff, gardening creators and stuff about gardening. Okay. All of that. But then one day, Lisa just happens to pop up on there. And they've never seen a beggar on TikTok or they've never encountered Lisa before.
Right.
We've been seeing Lisa pop up over and over again because we've been watching Lisa and we've been watching other beggars or we've been supporting, maybe you've supported or modded for a beggar even something has happened like that with you in the past. But for somebody that's on there that just starts following gardening, or they start following music, or they start following art, crafts, do home do-it-yourself projects. That's
Right.
what's in the algorithm. And then all of a sudden one day Lisa pops up and they've never seen Lisa before. So you have to understand that some of these people have not encountered this before. So I'm trying to be, understanding of that because the algorithm is different. You're right. Should do research before they just give cash. But honestly, a lot of these people don't know any better. It's their first time encountering something like this on TikTok. And they come up with sob stories and all of that. And okay, I saw you requested a box. Give me a moment. Try to be a little understanding because there are some people that this is legitimately the first time they've ever seen Lisa. Or
Right.
maybe just the second time, and they, right. All I see is scammers and like anti-scam and awareness people. And then every now and then there's something else thrown in. And if I happen to like that other thing thrown in, let's say, I'm watching scammers, I'm watching beggars, I'm watching awareness people. Then all of a sudden a video pops up of, I don't know, some little kids, no, let's say cat videos, funny cat videos. And then I like that. Well, all of a sudden, then the funny cat videos start and get mixed in, to my algorithm too. So it really just depends. Once you start liking and interacting with videos that are not within your normal genre, they do pop up. Somebody said if you go in there and all the comments are saying that stuff, she isn't a new person. Yeah, but like they don't always know what's, again, they don't know what's going on. A lot of people haven't encountered this before, Yeah, there are good people-hearted people that do believe these things. There are some people, a lot of people that have given to Jeff that I've talked to that are not giving to him anymore, but they truly, truly believed that God put it on their heart to help him.
And
Because
then the
he
scammers
uses,
use the words like blessing.
yes, when they use words like blessings and have a blessed day and all of that, and these people felt like they were doing something that God put it on their heart. Because they told me that out of their own words, and they thought they were doing the right thing and that God was telling them to do this. And I tried to tell them, would God rather you give money to a scammer on the internet? Or would they rather you donate it to a local organization or a church? I think God would rather if give it to a church than to someone on the internet. I mean, I don't believe in God and religion and all that, but I'm just saying if you do, You know, what do you think God would really want you to donate to? You know, just think about it. I mean, I wouldn't get donate to the church, but I'd give to a church over a scammer on the internet, you know.
Right.
Help people in your own community, you know. So sorry, that was a little soapbox thing here. Just a small town girl wanted to come up, requested the box. Welcome in. How are you today?
I'm good. I was just had posted it a lot of times in the comment because the comments were rolling so fast and I didn't know if you saw it. But I was wondering, what is the other page that y'all go watch that's for awareness? Because I just came across y'all this week.
Oh, are you talking about Scammy Claws or are you talking about Mexican Homie? You should check them both out. They're both good
Okay,
for
it's
different
Scammy
reasons.
Claws.
Yeah,
Yeah,
Scammy Claws
Scammy
without an
Claws.
E at the end.
Okay, and then the other one
She's
is
got two
what?
accounts. She's got two accounts, so follow them both. She covers Jen is Stronger, which is a whole rabbit hole you need to go down if you haven't. And
Looking
then
up
there's
the
Mexican Homie.
Okay.
Homie.
And right here in our chat is the B&B awareness page. I don't think she goes live right now, but she posts a lot of stuff about the scammers named Brendan and Branda. Brandon and Brenda, sorry. And she posts a lot of, and she says this is the exact reason that she started scam awareness. I'm looking at her message right now. So she's an awareness page. So some just post videos, but some do lives. These are Scammy Claus's accounts. I'll show them to you here.
'Cause the only one that I've been watching, and I'm sure y'all probably know, is Hippie Harley, also known as HH. She's a
Yeah.
scammer as well.
These top two right here, Scammy Claus 2.0, and I think Scammy Claus 2 is also one of her accounts.
Yeah, she's really funny. She's hilarious, and Mexican Homie is serious.
There we go. There's Scammy Claus 2.0. I know she does have another account too. I'm not sure where that is, but she
Okay,
might
well,
have
that's
it on private.
all I was wanting to
B&B, send
know.
her a follow. Okay, good B&B. You're very welcome. You're
I
very
just know
welcome. You
y'all
have
had went to watch somebody earlier and I couldn't find y'all, so I didn't know.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm
Yeah,
sorry. Yeah,
sorry
we
about
should have
that.
figured that out. Scammy Claus is going live later tonight too. She has some stuff, more stuff to reveal with regarding to Jen, and she's gonna have some of I guess some of Jen's family members are invited to join as well. So yeah, show the YouTube people. I'm not. Oh, the YouTube pe channels I follow. Okay, I'll show you. There is. This is where I watch a lot of live streams and some restreams. There's not as much Lisa on here. There's some, as you can see. There's one there at the top. Most of
Okay.
their videos, if you go to this page, see it's ISYBW, which stands for I See You Beautiful Warriors. So that's a good way to remember it. 5061. If you click on lives, they're not live streaming anyone right now, but if they were, it would show up here. But you can go back and watch any of the live streams. They just live streamed Lisa. So that video is here. They live streamed Jen earlier. So you can watch them on here instead of watching them on TikTok as well. And there's a whole other chat thing there. Kind of almost like what we're doing here. There's Chris Mosteller, which is Campfire Chris. So there's some Beth Osborne, Broken and Beautiful, which is Kim Peters. So there's a lot, and there's a lot of Jen. There's a lot of Jen on here. You can go back way far, and so yeah, there's
That's
lots of
sad.
videos on here.
All the gin you could ever handle.
Yeah,
Yeah,
there's a lot of
the
Jen.
Broken and Beautiful, that one I've seen her too, but I don't ever send money to anybody on TikTok. I just happened to come across Hippie Harley last year, and then I just happened to come across y'all this week whenever Tech was talking about it in her live one day.
Yeah.
So, all right, well, I appreciate it.
You are very welcome. And I'll show the other YouTube pages for everybody then too. I appreciate it. And I'll show you those as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, bye.
Thank you.
Somebody asked a question. Are you friends with that one weird mom? Not sure what to think of that crew. I don't say anything negative about other creators. I watch some of them, but not very often. Honestly, most of my time, I do watch Scammy Claws, and I do most of my rest of my time is spent actually watching the scammers and doing other work behind the scenes, contacting enablers and mods and other people who are doing things behind the scenes. That one weird mom, I have been in her live in her box a while back, and we talked about Lisa. She's been here in the box once or twice and has talked about Lisa. So I haven't watched her lately to know. I mean, I know she's still on talking about Lisa, but I don't know specifically, what's been going on over there. But I don't say anything, negative about other awareness creators. I hope she's being successful over there with what she's trying to do.
There's enough negativity in the community.
Yeah, no, I don't. Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I mean, I don't want to say anything negative about, anybody. I don't, if people want to say negative stuff about me, they can, but I don't do that. I try to not do that. Lisa will be back and asking for the cable bill money again tonight. Yeah. Campfire Chris, yes, SP has a lot of him. But yeah, I wouldn't say, I'm not really friends with really a lot of people even on TikTok. I mean, I'm friendly with people, but unless I really know you personally and have interacted with you like on a personal level, then it's hard for me to call somebody a friend. That's just kind of how I am. Caught Amanda B on yesterday morning, really? I did not know she was live yesterday.
Me either. I have to check out her Reddit page.
Let me show you the other YouTubes really quick, so that way you can get them on your list. Another one we watch a lot is Nookie5150. A lot of Lisa replays on here and other scammers. And
Nookie
then
Classic.
Kai Fati, and I will show you that.
Kai Fatsy is my go-to for sure.
Kai Fati. Oh, she has me on there, I think.
Look at that.
Lisa discussion from 4 hours ago. Oh, thank you, Kai. I didn't know
Thanks,
she was
Kai.
doing
We love you,
that. So
Kai.
Kai does some of restreams some of me, I guess.
That's so sweet. I'm honored.
Oh, that was when we were showing the Cash Apps and stuff, and wow, that's crazy. Caught Amanda B. Okay. Yeah, so there's my live, but you can scroll through and see lots of Lisa. Lots of Lisa. Somebody and again, if you want to email me any screenshots, video clips, anything that you think I sh you know might be helpful or you want me to show, I will review it and see if it's something that maybe we can include. Somebody did send me a video that I wanted to play. Let me make sure this is the right one. Now that's the Dirty House one. I don't know. Do we have, yeah, we did show that one. Let me see.
Yeah, but there's probably people here who haven't seen it.
We can show it again, but I'm trying to find the one that I missed. Okay, this is the one. Hold on a second. This is a clip from yesterday, I think. No. It's recent. She's wearing the black shirt. Okay, I'll show it, but she's wearing the black shirt. I didn't even notice it. I had to email this person back, so there was a delay. I was like, what am I looking for here? Because I was listening to her words and I thought I was listening here for her to say something effed up or something. You know what I mean? And so I was listening to what she was saying, and then I emailed her back, and I was like, "What am I looking for?" And she's like, "Look at the roaches on the wall over here." And I was like, "Oh shoot, I didn't even like see it." I was like, "Good catch," because I was trying thinking it was something words she was saying. So yeah, keep an eye on the left-hand side right there.
20 owed on the 10th of this month, but when I got the shut off, it says 40.
Did you see it? Did you guys see it? You didn't see it? Watch over
It'll
here.
be 20 owed on the 10th of this month.
Oh, you see it? Oh,
Here, I'll zoom in on it. Hold on.
lucky.
I'll zoom in on that part. Ready?
I got the heebs, the heebiest of jeebs.
This month.
Oh,
But when I got the
I
shut
can't
off,
with
it's
that.
40.
I can't. Oh, it's so gross.
Yeah, I'll show you. Watch right here.
It'll be 20 owed on the 10th of this month. But when I got the shut off, it says 40.
So somebody caught that and sent that to me? Unpaid actor. Yeah.
Yeah. I think that Lisa's roaches are even addicted to rack at this point.
Yep. So somebody caught that and sent it to me. So, if you catch something like that, or, you catch her saying something, anything, if you got some screenshots of messages that are out there, let me see what these are. Lisa picks. What's this? Oh, okay. This was one with a gift. That was fun. Those are funny. This is the one of her house, I think. Let me make sure. Yep. This is the one of her house. If you haven't seen it, somebody sent me the link to the Reddit too, but this is like a little clip. Get a good look right here. Litter box. This is the floor, the carpet.
Mattress on the floor.
Yeah. A not clean mattress. Yeah, that was just the short clip. Let me see if I can find the long clip because somebody sent it to me in my email. Or no, in my messages on TikTok, I think. They sent it to me on Reddit, the Reddit link. Oh, here it is. I'm going to have to save this. Hold on a second.
Bro, this is disgusting. She just doesn't even care.
I'm going to save it.
About all this cat shit?
Nope. We
have to clean up. This is the full clip. All right. Are you guys ready? I hope you're not eating your dinner.
Yeah, right.
Trigger warning. You can't see it? No, this is Abby's ex-boyfriend who showed up. It's the person videoing it is Abby's ex-boyfriend that showed up, and I guess he was looking for Abby, and Abby wasn't there, but Jace let him in the house and while Lisa was asleep. But Jace knew him, and felt comfortable letting him in the house. That's at least the story that I heard. Okay. Yeah. So Abby's ex showed up looking for Abby. Abby was not there. He asked if he didn't mind if he'd come in anyway. Jace had answered the door. He allowed him in. Lisa was asleep. I think he kind of wanted to double check and make sure Abby wasn't there because I think this may be Abby's room. And he wanted to check if she was there or whatever. And yeah, so I think it's Abby's ex. It's an apartment building. They wouldn't condemn it. I mean, they'll do whatever with it.
Lisa?
She said, yeah, I don't even live in her. So you should probably.
Bro, this is disgusting.
I know.
She just doesn't even care. She doesn't care about this at all?
I think she does, but she doesn't clean it.
There's like bugs everywhere.
I know.
Where's Lisa?
So it's replaying. Let me see if I can see when that was. Give me a second. It was recorded in September. So, like 7 months ago. Supposedly she did clean up some after that, but I don't think a lot, to be honest with you. So this was September, this past September. I'll show it again. Yeah, it does sound like Jace is embarrassed and didn't know what to say about it. Right. He says Lisa's sleeping, and then, Abby's ex-boyfriend is questioning him about it. Like, why is she not doing anything about this?
Where's Lisa?
She's sleeping. I asked her, she said, yeah, I don't even live in her. So you should probably...
Bro, this is disgusting.
I know.
She just doesn't even care about all this cat shit.
Nope. We have to clean up.
She doesn't care about this at all?
I think she does, but she doesn't clean it.
There's like bugs everywhere.
I know.
Where's Lisa?
She's sleeping.
So, yeah.
Disgusting. And when poop dries, it like breaks off into particles and goes into the air and literally can attach in your lungs.
Well, supposedly, some people, including one of her sisters and stuff, did go over there and help her to clean some of that up. I don't know how. I mean, they did show a picture after, and it did look like the floors were at least cleaned up. And this, like, some of the stuff was off of the floor. But they did that right after this. And so it's been a couple of months, if she hasn't been maintaining it right, did it stay clean? Kind of doubt it. Jason's with his paternal grandparents and his brother. He was removed by CPS, but he's with family. But that's, if she didn't maintain things, it may look like this again. I don't know. But I mean,
Ugh.
where did he even get to this point? I think this
Right.
is Abby's room.
Yeah. Abby's an adult. She could have cleaned this.
Well, but she's not there all the time either. She was mainly living with her boyfriend or ex-boyfriend or whoever it was at the time. She there's times where she's not there for months at a time. So apparently Lisa was almost like locking the cats in this room with this litter box. So they were just doing whatever in this room. So yeah, you're right. But I don't really think at that time that Abby was there very often, but
Yeah.
I'm just
I don't even
saying.
think Abby lived there at the time, actually, if I remember
I
correctly.
mean, she's just been there like off and on, you
No,
know what I
just to
mean?
like feed her cats, like here and there.
And check on Jace, and stuff, because she did go there to check on Jace, I know, sometimes and stuff. Give me just a moment. I'm just checking here.
And Abby has TikToks where she expresses the feeling of being overwhelmed because her mom expects her to parent Jace.
Yes.
And confirming that she's pregnant as well.
So people were asking about this video. So this is the one that I posted on my TikTok. It is there if you want to see it for yourself, where Lisa was going on live and she didn't realize that the live had started. I guess it started quicker than she thought, and it caught her in the beginning smoking something. So once you see the smoke and you look at what's in her hand, I think you'll know what's going on here. I'm going to show you my video, and then I'm going to show you what she did to my video. All right. This is in slow motion because it happens so fast. There's the smoke. And then watch right here in her hand. Anyway. And I get. Might have to move the phone up because of the chat.
Yeah, that definitely is not cigarette smoke, for sure.
And I have some screenshots that were kind of like cleaned up. Like, there's the smoke. There's the device. There's the device.
And it has a reflection, because things that are glass and shiny get a reflection.
Yeah,
Boom,
for
and there
sure.
it is.
So then I had that posted on my page, on my TikTok, without any sound or anything. And twice Lisa reposted that video on her own, two of her own TikTok pages. She posted one on there with music that sang about rugs. And then it either got a community guidelines violation or she removed it. And then she reposted it again, I believe early this morning, again with music about rugs. And it again was either removed by TikTok or by her, but this time I was able to save the video before it got deleted.
Yay.
Yes, she did talk about it, but she either took it down or TikTok removed it. But for the first time, I wasn't able to save it before it got removed, it was removed, but this time I did. So this is what she posted on her TikTok, and you can see it says Loving Life XO here at the bottom. Is the music on? Oops, I don't have the music on. Here. Now listen, because I didn't have that music on it. No, Danny. But her family member came in here today and yesterday and spoke with us. No, I don't watch the Drama Twins. I don't like them. I don't know, Master Peanut.
So did you guys hear that sound? It was rack like this. Is what I'm saying.
Because that's not what the original song is. I don't know. She accused Mama Julie of stealing from some of her funds, but I don't know if that's true or not. Yeah, it's like she's proud of it. It was kind of like throwing it back up in everybody's face because I posted it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and like the cooking sound in the beginning. Yeah. They're smoking, you know, bubbles. Mama Julie was helping Lisa. Yeah, I don't know if it's true or not. But I know that Mama Julie person was a beggar too. It's just crazy to me. That's some bold shit. Right, I always mean. Thank you, Danny. So, hello, Leland.
So interesting.
You know, well, what? Yeah, I mean, she's spending time doing this and like reposting this video and adding music to all that, like, and doing all this crazy stuff online. And she's not taking any effort to try to get Jace back. I'm sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
She's on C-Rack, plus she goes to the methadone clinic. She's been going there for like 19 years. And benzos. I do not know Abby's TikTok offhand. It's like bunny baby, you know, something like that. Bunny baby something. The father, I don't know what he ID'd from. I think it might have been H. When Jess, Lisa's sister, was in the box yesterday, she said that Lisa was doing H while she was pregnant.
Yes, she did. She said that, and that was, you know, shocking but not shocking at the same time.
You think Abby did it, meaning posted the video? No, I don't think so.
No. Mm-mm.
Lisa was mentioning it.
Yeah.
After she posted it, she was saying, hey, have you guys seen my new video? Have you seen my new video? And this was the only new one on there.
She's bragging.
Like, she was kind of like bragging about it. But then later on, it ended up getting removed. So I don't know, again, if she removed it or if TikTok removed it for a community guidelines violation. I do know that mine without the music has not been removed. So it could have been that she added this music, to, you know, singing about C-Rack.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's not doing what she's supposed to be doing. Is this what a person who's trying to get their child back spends their time on?
Right.
Yeah, Lisa posted this on her page.
Yeah. And she added this music about C-Rack. Yeah. About over the video. So that was interesting.
Yeah.
That was really shocking when we saw that. I was like, what? Yeah, it was crazy.
Jamie, I'm not sure because I don't remember like when you left and came back. Like, I'm not sure. Like, yeah, they're supposed to be weaning her off at the clinic, but my understanding is they only do it as the person's kind of comfortable with it. And if she doesn't show interest in doing that, then I guess they just keep doing business as usual. Yeah, so that's what people have been saying. It was like she was trying to rub it in our faces with this video.
Right.
And like, so what? Like, I can do whatever I want, you know?
Right.
But she thought that before. She thought before, oh, I can do whatever I want. They're not going to take Jace and all that. Well, look what happened.
That's what I was just going to say. She was like, they're not going to take Jace away from me. You can call CPS all you want. It's not going to matter. And boom, look what happened.
Yeah, she's been going there for 19 years. Could I have a quick update? I've been out of the pub 2:15 here. Well, I mean, you really have to catch up by trying to watch her videos, probably on Kai Fati. She was live.
Yeah.
I don't know what time it is there. I don't know if you caught that live. Like, yeah, she was getting mad. It was actually really funny. People were sending gifts, and it was here. I can show you those. I have the other ones here on my other phone, so I can't show them all to you. I'll make a little video of them or something, or like a collage or something, or show them to you. Give me a second here. They're in my email.
So that was interesting.
So a bunch of people had gotten modded, and they unblocked a whole bunch of people, and Lisa got really mad, and people were over there saying to come to Scam Slam's page, so a lot of them came over here to find out the truth, and we were, you know, telling people what was going on, and then people were, like, sending gifts, and they were funny because they were coming to me, but they were going on to her.
It was great.
We got a bunch of screenshots of those. So again, I appreciate the gifts. You didn't have to do that, but it was hilarious, like, you know, because they were popping up on her like that. So I have a whole bunch of them screenshotted. What happened before she got off? Did she get the money? I'm not sure. She was really angry. Okay, so the other big thing was she created a brand new Cash App. I think she just started using it yesterday. I think it was Lisa. Please help Lisa.
Yeah, Lisa. Yeah.
It started either yesterday or today. So when I first got on, I brought up my Cash App and I showed people how to report her Cash App. And a bunch of people here and elsewhere, I'm sure, were reporting her new Cash App. So partway through her live, she started getting upset because saying that her Cash App wasn't working. Yeah, the elephant was funny. I have that on this phone. So I, you know, Wallflower, it's crazy. PA, New York, CA, it's all Democrat states. Rugs are legal. False. False.
Right.
And I don't want politics brought in this because, believe me, you don't want to bring up politics with me. Pennsylvania, marijuana is not even legal. It's only for medical. A close family member just actually got charges for it and had to actually go to jail over it.
That is crazy.
It is still a jailable offense in a lot of areas of Pennsylvania. So please don't spread misinformation. And please do not bring up politics again in here. Thank you. I'm saying it very respectfully.
Right.
Somebody in Christie sent her a large amount of money. Yeah, I did see that. Yeah, and you're right, Billy. But again, we'll keep politics out. But you're right, Billy. Anyone called about the dog? Someone did contact me about the dog and getting some more information to hopefully have something happen. But I haven't been able to check my messages to see if there's been any update about that. What account does she use? There's so many of them. The one she was using today was that Loving Life XOXOXOXO account. I mean, no, I love politics, but that's not what this channel is.
Yes. Thank you, Amy. Thank you so much.
I'm not Lisa. My name is Julie. I've never heard of that, Terry. I have no idea what that even is. I'm sorry. Not even medically legal in Wisconsin. Wow. Yeah. Wow. I mean, all around us it is. Yeah. I mean, yeah, New York, it's weed is legal. 420. I'm going to say 420. 420 is legal. And New York, it's legal in New Jersey now. It's legal, I believe, in Maryland. It's been legal in D.C. for a long time. It's legal in Virginia. I'm not sure about West Virginia. Maybe somebody knows about that. I'm not sure about Ohio on the other side. But, you know, literally, like, we're all surrounded by legal places. But Pennsylvania is...
I have a dispensary literally across the street.
You're
I'm
lucky.
So blessed.
You're so lucky.
And they love me, too. So it's wonderful. Yes. Samples, trade samples. Hello.
Yeah, it's so you're so lucky because nothing is legal here, and people are still going to jail and being incriminated for it. Thank you, Leland.
Oh, I love the corgi.
You're being incriminated for it, and having to, get there. People were being forced to go to drug and alcohol classes. I'm sorry, drug and alcohol classes, just because they were caught with a small amount of 420. They ended up getting probation for a year, having to go to drug and alcohol classes and pay probation fees for a year plus fine and costs. And then when the person completed all of that, at the end of it, they thought they had paid everything off, but apparently they still owed $100 for their fines that they like thought that they had paid, and they actually showed up at this person's job and put them in jail. Over $100 that they still owed from this 420 charge.
That is so dumb. Oh my
Yes. Oh
goodness.
yeah, but this is how it is here. So
Oh my gosh, Saving God's Grace just came in and said that she's being unblocked and modded again.
Oh my gosh. Hold on, Jennifer. Yes, feel free to send me something about someone else. You can either message me on TikTok. Or if it's something where you need to send videos or screenshots, you can send those to scamslam411 at gmail.com.
Look at your nails. I love that picture.
People are requesting to get unblocked. How would you? Wait, I'm looking for a. Did she put a message in here?
Yeah.
I'm looking
Yeah, it's
for
in the comments. It's a little ways back now.
Oh, sorry. I got on my soapbox for a minute. It really sucks with our situation here with all of that 420 stuff.
Yeah, it does. It's not
Being
fair.
unblocked and modded again. Wow. Did
Texting her now. Yay!
you like really like, what did you have to do? Did you have to like apologize? Please tell me you didn't have to. She did try to make you like send her money or something.
I'm
'Cause that,
sure. I'm
yeah, I wouldn't do
sure.
that. I wouldn't do that.
No. Don't give her a dime. In fact, when
Oh,
people
I'm so
send her pennies,
sorry.
it's a penny more than she deserves.
I'm so sorry, love dogs, that you've been at the hospital with your mom. I hope she's okay. I really
Sorry.
do. I hope well for all of you. I don't know if she's
Yeah.
gonna get help. It's not because PA is a commonwealth, it's just our politicians are a-holes. Most of them.
Right.
I mean, our governor, our no, our governor's all in favor of it, but and some others, but yeah. I mean, a lot of us just go to New Jersey.
Ooh, thanks, Saved by God's Grace. My email is in my bio, so send it there.
So yeah, unblock whoever you can, I guess. People ratted out the neighbor. She's gonna know now. What?
I don't know. I think that might be about like Lisa's neighbor or whatever supposedly was in there, but I don't know. All that's unconfirmed. I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't know.
She has her minions in here. She probably does. Hi, minions. I
Oh, you think Lisa has her minions in here? I don't really think Lisa has minions.
don't think so either.
All right, I have three people who put in requests, and I don't know if they intended to. So speak now or forever hold your peace. Well, not forever. Speak now in the next 2 minutes or hold your peace until later. Master Peanut, Lisa, and Gangsta Mama. If you want to be in the box, just speak up in the comments
Lisa
and you can
did.
come up.
Lisa did.
Lisa wants to? Okay.
A good Lisa. Not
Yeah.
the
Yeah, no, different Lisa.
Yes, I'm not that Lisa.
Different Lisa. The good
Lisa.
Lisa.
First off, I want to say that I love watching you and Polly. Of course, Polly makes me crack up laughing, but today wasn't a good day. I got a broken rib, but that's okay.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
But I wanted to bring up a story. There was a woman who had just been on for a little while, never came across a scammer. She had just found out she had cancer.
And
I don't know if you remember Shannon Gardner. She
yes.
also went by Butterfly Kisses.
Mm-hmm.
That woman gave her last $20 to her because she fell for her scam. Didn't know. Well, that woman was me.
Oh.
And as soon after I did that, somebody contacted me, told me that I had just been scammed. And I fell for it. It broke my heart because she said she needed medication. And I ended up giving her my last 20. And the person who actually contacted me says, do you have a Cash App? She did give me back my money. But I just wanted to put out there, if you've never came across the scammer, be forewarned. They will pull at every heartstring that you have. I was literally in tears when I gave her the money. And I just wanted to kind of give a heads up to anybody who has not been met with a scammer. Just do research. I do my research now. And because of Scan Slam and Scammy, I have learned to watch what I'm doing. And I don't fall for them no more. But I just wanted, to make people aware that the new people do have hearts and sometimes will fall prey to them.
Right. And there's certain things you can look for. They use a certain lingo like blessings instead of, money. And also they'll have like their cash forms in their bio for their forms for collecting. I don't want to say the names of them. Their forms are collecting in their bio. They'll have like Amazon wish lists in their bio. There's things to watch out for. Every day it's a new thing they need money for. Every day. Always a new thing.
I was in a group and I had just met Dora the Explorer, of course, and her group actually went into Shannon Gardner's her profile when she was online, and she denied she ever did it, but I had proof and I showed them. And one of the groups, I don't know if you remember, Dee was in there. She gave me back the 20 and everything, which I was happy she did because, it left me hurting and
right.
everything. And, I have asked for help myself, but that was because my food stamps had went down for some reason. They said I didn't refile when I did, but they didn't look at the paperwork, so I wasn't getting my food money at all.
Yeah.
And plus going through the cancer and stuff,
well,
I had two surgeries.
Scenario. That's not begging daily, for calls.
Yeah.
All these
And I
things.
Have, I don't ask no more for help. It's just, at that time I was going through the two cancer surgeries and I don't know if I'm going to have surgery again. So that's kind of in the limbo. Right now I'm in remission, but I'm having other problems right now. I told you, Polly, in direct message what's going on with me now and everything, that the surgery has left me with severe anemia. So I'm going to have to probably have blood transfusions. I don't know. But I just wanted to get on and try to give my story about what happened to me. I got my heartstring pulled, and I know now, before I even think of donating, I come on here to Scam Slam and scam me before I even did. And even when Jen had got out of rehab, I was in her life for a while and everything. I didn't donate no money or anything because, I don't do that no more. I did gift her a couple times with gifts till I've heard about the phone call of the hit.
Yeah, that was me. I recorded that.
I actually went in her live and told her about it. I yelled at her for that. And I got blocked by NC Sunshine. Well, now she's on our
side.
Side.
Yeah, she's on the side. Yeah.
Yeah. And, I'm not mad at her for doing that because she just didn't see the light till a little later than I did. So she finally left. But I just want people to be aware. Don't let them pull at your heart. Don't let them do it because it tore me apart. And, I was already going through a lot of stuff and I just felt bad for her.
Right.
But I won't do it again. And if someone comes at me again, I'm gonna come to you guys and say, hey, this person's hitting me up for money, you know. And yep. I have got a friend request from Jennifer Martin. And of course it went right to block.
Yeah.
No way.
Right? That's the whole thing.
Yeah, but that's all I wanted to really say. I just wanted to, you know, make sure any new people know that they will pull your heartstrings and try to get what they can get.
Exactly. Yeah.
And Lisa, I'm so sorry that happened to you and the current challenges that you're going through. And when something like that happens, it's not just that you lost the money, you know, it's that it emotionally hurts you. You know, because a lot of times it was someone that maybe you thought was your friend or that you trusted or that you believed in or had a lot of high hopes for. And they just violated all of that, you know. And so it's not just the $10, $20, $30, whatever was donated. It's not just the money. It's that, you know, it breaks a little piece of your heart. And so it's emotionally, you know, hurts you emotionally, too. What happened to you? And just because we are, you know, these awareness people and stuff, you know, that doesn't mean that we don't have a heart.
Right.
Yeah, I know you guys do.
Absolutely.
It's just, you know, we're trying to save people money, but I do donate, but they're only to the, there's a homeless girl that hangs out in the shopping center, you know, where we live. And she's been on the streets since I've been here. And I've been here over a year where I'm living now. When I'm out or when my daughter goes out, we try to donate a little bit of money because she's always hungry. So we usually get, you know, buy her food and take it to her and everything. Or, you know, if she wants a couple bucks for something different, we'll let her have it, you know. But other than that, I don't help anybody online.
Right.
You know, unless they can prove it to me, you know. But, I mean, I lost faith in giving any kind of money on TT at all.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Aw, thank you, Renee. Yeah, we encourage people. We encourage people to really not donate, you know, any money to anybody on TikTok and donate to your local organizations. And when people need help, then they should go to their local organizations as resources or assistance, you know?
Yes. That's what they need to do.
I appreciate your story, Lisa. I'm glad that we were hopefully able to help you in some way. And if we can be of further assistance or anything like that, you just let us know.
Yeah, you can always message.
Okay, I will. I've got Paranormal Polly. I always direct message her, talk to her.
Yeah.
And everything. Because she makes me laugh when she laughs.
Wonderful.
I love her laugh.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Lisa. Okay. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I wish you the luck with your upcoming health issues. I really do.
Yes.
You guys have a good evening too. Maybe you might be on later and I might be on with
Lisa
you.
Lisa comes back. Yep, sure.
We'll be there.
Okay.
And thanks, Lisa.
I have Jesse and Gangster Mama. If you would like to come up in the box, please let me know. Please confirm in the comments.
Mm-hmm.
Got about 2 minutes because if not, I will end it for now.
Yeah.
And then, me says Jesse.
Hey, Jesse.
Just message me. Hi, Jesse.
Hey, y'all.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, girl. Hey.
So I've been watching y'all and listening to all the scam stuff, and everybody so desperately wants Lisa to go to rehab. And I get that. I do. And everybody's like, well, I mean, her child's gone. You know, is that not her rock bottom? Everybody's rock bottom is different.
Yep.
It is. My husband, true story about his biological mother. She left my husband when he was 2 years old, about 2 years old, at the rug dealer's house on accident, and kidnapped another child in Florida thinking it was her son. And this is in like the early 80s. We didn't have social media back then. Your face was on like a milk carton. And it took them about 3 years for his grandparents to find him in Memphis, which is like almost 2 hours from here.
Mm. Wow.
And then come to find out, Well, Stephen, he was a little white kid in an African-American neighborhood. And the neighbors were like, wait a minute, you know, something's off here. So if it wasn't for that, you know, there's no telling where he would have ended up at.
Right.
But I mean, his mama was so messed up that she left him, kidnapped another child, and didn't even know.
Right.
She comes home with this other kid, and they're like, that's not Steven.
Crazy.
And I mean, that is sad.
I'm a little confused by your story. Is there something that you're saying that relates to Lisa?
Yeah. Well, I mean, what I'm saying is everybody, I mean, I know everybody wants her to go to rehab and get treatment. And everybody's like, my gosh, you know, your child is gone. So where's your rock bottom? Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. Everybody's rock bottom is different. And she's so far deep in her addiction, I don't think she knows what she's doing.
Right.
Yeah, sometimes she seems so out of it. And like earlier today when she was calling somebody, it was like she didn't even know who she was talking to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was crazy.
Like, I think half the time she doesn't even know who she's talking to, who she's messaging. Like, she's confused.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Completely.
Yep.
Anyway, that was my one little story. That's the only story I had. But I love watching y'all. I love the commentary.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really do appreciate it.
Yes. Y'all have a good day.
Thank you. You too. Enjoy the rest of your day, and let's see what the rest of the evening holds here.
No, right?
Yep. Absolutely. Thank you. All right. Well, you see yourself in the picture? Yeah. I have a bunch more. I'll have to get them together. They're funny. They're definitely funny. Did something happen between her and Julie? Yeah, it sounds like it. Lisa was accusing that Julie person of taking some of her money. So, yeah. Let me see. Yeah, there was someone in the comments named Cece that I addressed. Where did a comment go? Saying, I guess because we're showing that, you know, there was a gift here. No one talking about Lisa Richards should ever take gifts. IMO.
Well, I'm glad you have your own opinion.
Yeah. I mean, no, it's fine. You know, and people responded and said, you know, we didn't ask for gifts, which we don't. And my response said, okay, run your own awareness account that way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Everybody can do what they want. Like, I don't care if other awareness people accept gifts, don't accept gifts, have subscriptions, don't have subscriptions. Like,
don't care.
Yeah, I don't hate on anybody doing awareness. I maybe, you know, hate a little bit on scammers, but you know, that's about
right.
It. And this stuff was funny when it was, you know, they were popping up on Lisa's page. So,
oh my gosh, so funny. You guys, this was the most fun live. I don't know about y'all, but my belly hurts. I laughed so hard.
Yeah, I thought it was great. Funny.
Thank you, Tilly. It was so great. I had a blast.
I think it was funny and hilarious. So I appreciate all of you that participated today. I really, really do. Some parts of it were so funny. And the whole mod situation with Lisa was hilarious, too. Whole bunch of you got unblocked. It was so funny. Yeah, we re-gift these. You know, we re-gift these to other people. You know, so it isn't like we're, I don't know.
I'm doing something awesome. I have a plan, and it's going to be very awesome. It's going to benefit puppies.
This is not my, like, I have an actual job, and I don't actually even need to work. Like, I have money, so, you know, I don't need the gifts. They're just fun, and I do appreciate them because I, you know, they're fun to give. I like to re-gift them back to other people. I think it's fun. So, yeah, that's all. I'm sorry if you're just coming in, but we're just getting off because I need a break, you guys. I've been talking for a long time. I need to check a bunch of messages. And I'm sure that, yeah, I donate to a lot of charities. And I actually volunteer time to my local food bank, too, helping put together food boxes. So, anyways, yeah, I do want to get off here for a little bit. I know some of you have said you have sent me messages and have sent me information that you want me to check and things to review. So I am going to try to review all of that stuff. I don't know.
I do. Caitlin is a beggar and she keeps coming in here. And today I was like, hey girl, hey.
Oh, that's what you said. See, I didn't even remember who you were talking about.
Yeah, I was talking about you the other night. I said she keeps coming into our lives. And I'm like, girl, don't you know? Haven't you heard? Do you not see the name?
Well, no, I didn't remember her name, and I've never actually seen her live or anything like that. But no, let's not harass her or anything like that.
No.
She's coming in here, whatever. And as long as she's respectful and all that, she can be here. I'm not going to block her. We're not going to harass her and stuff like that. She can be here. You know, now if she starts getting disrespectful or she starts hitting up people in here for money or asking here in the lives or anything like that, you know.
Then it's different. Yeah. No. I'm not mean to her or anything. No. I go and watch her lives. Mm-hmm. She knows who I am.
Okay. All right, perfect. So I'm going to check my messages. If any of you have messaged me and you're waiting on a response, I apologize if there's a delay. I am going to check them now and get through some of those. If you see Lisa live, feel free to also message me so we can get back on it.
Yeah, and it's all good right. When you send the live, you not just send the live, you send a message that says, you know, Lisa's live. That way it comes across the screen, not just because I get sent beggars like all day, every day. So I get shared lives constantly. So I never know if the live you're sharing me is a live for Lisa, unless you type Lisa is live. And then I'm like, oh, okay.
Well, and there's been a couple people that have shared Lisa's live and Lisa blocked them because she had a feeling that they were sharing it to the other side, as they
just
say.
Just a message that Lisa's live is perfect. I don't even need a video. Just a message that says, hey, Lisa's live. Like, that's all I need.
Absolutely. Yep, absolutely. All right. Well, thank you again so much. I really appreciate you guys, and maybe I will see you later. Thank you for a very fun live.
The funnest. It was the best.